Hi, this is Billy. I finally completed the work on my passive vertical hydroponics grow tower. And all the components, most of it is 3D printed, including the base. The base here will collect any dripping water that accidentally dripped or because of some leakage of some pipes, or when you pour the nutrient, you accidentally spilt some nutrient. Just to repeat, this is not a circulating or recycling system. Nothing will be recycled. So you can see this darker color one. It is the nutrient tank. This is the nutrient level indicator. So it's now full. You can take a look inside. So the nutrient is piled in through this small tube here, and then it will fill up the entire tank. There will be central pipes passing from the nutrient tank, the duct pipe here, into the flow valve. And the flow valve keeps the nutrient level at each tank at around 1 inch. The white line here is the electric cable for the grow light. The grow lights are LED grow lights, 18 watts. It's a full spectrum white color grow light. This one I have is 4 feet. And so this nutrient tank is responsible for the 3 growth tank down there. It contains the nutrient solution with EC 2.4. It will be enough for the tomatoes and this type of fruity plants. Okay. And if you go up at the top, there's another nutrient tank. This dark color nutrient tank is for the vegetable. It contains the nutrient solution of 1.5 EC 1.5, which should be okay for most vegetable. And of course at the far top you have the adjustable distance LED grow light. You can adjust the distance like that. Okay, don't pull too far away. So this is very, very far away, and you can push it in. Depending on the size of your plant, you can adjust it. You notice that this system has no pumps, no electric pumps, no air pumps, so it's completely silent. Not even dripping water, nothing like that. The flow valve will gradually let the nutrient pass down to each tank. Like this nutrient tank responsible for the 3 growth tank down here, they are all growing different type of vegetables. This is lettuce, this is some salad vegetable, and the bottom one is pak choi. And then from time to time we can take a look at the root system and also the flow valve situation. So each growth tank has a central standpipe. It's very important because it allows the nutrient solution to pass down through the thick black pipe, and then it allows the electric grow light to pass down through the central pipe. Unlike the other power system where electric cable is flying out from the far top, which is a little bit ugly and dangerous, this one passes down the central pipe and exit out there, so at the base. For the base, you may want to put in a bigger board to stabilize it. Otherwise, if there's a big wind blowing from the window, this whole tower may move and tilt. So it may be better to secure the top with a wire to your window. So even if it's going to fall, there's still some strings restraining it. Make sure it didn't fall down. Okay, that's all I have for today. I will be releasing an instruction video step by step on how to clean the different modules and how to make the whole system. Thank you.